Hi children, welcome to EduCab. This is Unit 10, Electricity. According to the lesson, as a third part, I have divided this lesson into four parts. They are heating effect of electric current, light effect of electric current, chemical effect of electric current, and magnetic effect of electric current. Here, today's our topic is heating effect of electric current. When an electric current is flowing through a wire, electric energy is transformed to heat. Therefore, the conducting wires get heated. This is called the heating effect of electric current. To check whether the heating effect of electric current, here we have to do an activity. We will need a filament bulb, two electric cells, a switch, and connecting wires. Let's see what we have to do. Connect the bulb, two electric cells, and the switch like this. Touch the glass cover of the bulb. Close the switch and let electric current flow for a few seconds. Touch the glass cover of the bulb again. Take the observation. Observation will be, you can feel that the bulb has heated after flow of electricity for some time. That reveals the heating effect of electric current. So, conclusion, current has heating effect. There's a second activity to observe heat effect of electric current. Here you will need a nichrome wire and a copper wire of same length and thickness, a piece of plank, three nails, a dry cell, a switch, connecting wires, and a hammer. Let's see what we have to do. Fix the three nails A, B, and C on the plank, keeping 30 cm gap between each other. Tie the copper wire between A and B nails and nichrome wire between B and C nails. Both wires should be well stretched. Then connect the nails A and C of the plank to the switch and dry cell with connecting wires. Touch the copper and nichrome wires. Then close the switch for about 1 minute to allow current flow and touch two wires again. Discuss your observation. Observation will be same electric current flows to both wires, but nichrome wire is heated more than the copper wire. For the conclusion, heating effect of an electric current depends on the resistance and the current flowing through a conductor. When the resistance of the conductor is high, more heat is generated. When the current flowing through a conductor is high, more heat is generated. Resistance of a conductor depends on the material is made of. Its length and its thickness also depend on it. Thickness means the area of cross section. And for the resistance of a conductor depend on three factors. They are the material it made, length, and the thickness. So very thin, long nichrome wires are used in electric appliances in which heat is generated using heating effect of the electricity. Heating effect of electricity is a disadvantage in some electrical appliances. Various methods are used to avoid damages that happen due to the heat generated in them. Heating effect of electricity is disadvantage in some electric appliances. such as computers, cooling fans are used to cool such appliances. Heavy duty semiconductors such as transistors produce heat, therefore heat sink is used to cool the appliance. Our second topic is light effect of electric current. Let's meet in the next video.